All right, hello. Introductions are in order for some of you, I guess. My name's Casey Murdoch, born Ken Call Murdoch, gone by Casey my entire life. I am now 46. My birthday is December 3rd, 1974. So what am I doing and why am I doing this? This is for friends and family who know me and want to actually know what's going on with my health and life. On my personal YouTube, one of many YouTube channels I have. This one is not really, I don't do a whole lot of public stuff on it, so I thought this would be a good place since this is where I have my sister Tina's memorial video that I put on there up there. This would be a good place to get on here and get personal about my own health issues. Okay, how do we catch up with a very fast wrap up? Currently partially disabled, depends on the day. I have good days, I have bad days with aggressive arthritis and neuropathy, both of which cause different issues that can work together against me or separate. And then the debatable part on whether I had COVID or not. And because, the post-COVID symptoms, I have them all. And a lot of those symptoms also mimic and go along with arthritis and neuropathy issues as well. Also, because of the blood restrictions and nerve damage that COVID-19 causes that the doctors still can't figure out. So, got all that on top of what was already going on with my arthritis and neuropathy over the last few years. And so, the last year, 2020, sucked for everyone I know, but it definitely made my health go downhill really fast compared to how it was going downhill over the previous 3 years. So about 4 years ago, I was having issues with, I was having pain in my neck and more headaches than usual and things going on, and then helped a friend with a THC CBD rub, putting it together and getting the science behind it a little better and getting it better, and that was helping and whatnot. Went through some personal stuff, and then that summer, the pain got worse. All through spring, the pain was getting worse in my lower back too, as I was working at a restaurant, with two different levels as a 40-year-old, running circles around a bunch of 20-year-olds. No matter how much I complain about pain to any of, my employers, they never did anything but work me harder. And being in the restaurant industry for 20 years, you never get insurance. You don't get insurance. It's impossible because you don't work enough hours, or even if you do work enough hours, it's just not part of the restaurant industry. So for 20 years, I've gone without medical attention and never really needed it anyway because I was always pretty healthy, or thought I was pretty healthy. Maybe I was just probably, drinking too much and drinking past the pain. So how many people are out there doing that, self-prescribing for their own pain? That's America, America the Great, yay. So I was doing my normal daily workout, and I was doing some push-ups, and I felt something pinch in my fucking neck, and that's when things started getting really worse, pain-wise, and different things, and headaches, and lockjaw, all kinds of things with my jaw, and I've been singing my entire life, so that just made me, singing is what I've always done through stress and through good times and bad times. So I was singing even more and more often while I was actually going to church and doing double church services on Sundays. So I was singing even more, because I was trying to praise the pain away and all, while singing, and just making things worse because I didn't realize I had jaw arthritis. Went and saw a doctor who told me I had TMJ, didn't run any blood work, didn't do anything, just listened to my symptoms and fucking cut me off halfway through and was like, "You have TMJ." So I just assumed I had TMJ and left it at that and tried to take away stress from my life, which I did. Did a pretty good job of. But things things got worse from there at when I started Lyft driving, and then I got in an office to sell some insurance. I'm in my bedroom. I spend a lot of time in here because I can't stand walk as much as I could in the past, and I can't sit either. But that's what I was about to get to. I've always had sitting issues because I was in a car accident in 2001 where I totaled my vehicle. And the doctor back then told me that I bruised my tailbone and that was going to cause me pain issues for the rest of my life. He was not lying. He was 100% correct. One of the few doctors that have been correct with me. So that's made traveling and driving long distances extremely difficult ever since then for the last, 20 years. So now, all of a sudden, now I'm Lyft driving, and now I'm losing feeling in my feet. After a couple hours of driving. So, and then I lost all control of both my hands, at the same time while driving down the freeway, which was not fun. Luckily I was on my way home and didn't have passengers with me, but that was when I realized I had to stop Lyft driving because, I mean, that's dangerous to me, passengers, and anyone else on the road or around me. That's just stupid. I can't be out there on the road with what that was happening. And it was, that's from driving all day. And every job I've ever had, I've been on my feet and I've used my hands. So the arthritis in my feet and hands are fucking horrible, which is kind of pain on anyone. And I've been singing my entire life since before I could talk. So the jaw arthritis is insane. I wouldn't wish that on anyone ever. It's so it wasn't TMJ. So a year goes by and I finally get to another doctor, and because the pain in the back and the neck and everything, just everything's going just so painful, I go see another doctor, and he's like, oh well, sends me for x-rays, blah blah blah, go in to look at the x-rays. It's like, oh okay, well, you got 8 pinched nerves in your neck and you got 6 lower pinched in your lumbar, your lower back, so that's probably what's causing all these issues for you. I'm going to refer you to a spinal specialist and a pain specialist and a spinal surgeon. Unfortunately, I didn't really get too far with all of that because I moved a few weeks later to San Diego. And in San Diego has different Medicaid than the rest of California does, which is another reason I'm all about free healthcare for all and make it universal across this country. Insurances, you know what? My mom raised me off her Aflac money, but insurances are the cancer of the healthcare system and this society. They are a dredge on this society. How do I know that? Because I got my insurance license and learned way too much about insurance. So, yeah. wish I'd have known all that before, but it was a good learning lesson. But, brain fog. Where was I going with this? See, that's that. Lose focus so fast, so easy. Forget words, forget song lyrics I've been singing for 40 years. It's ridiculous. But yeah, jaw arthritis, all that. So that was 3 years ago. And that started 5 years ago. And then 4 years ago, I found out about the pinched nerves and whatnot. So that all kind of started going downhill and getting worse. I noticed, so the nerve damage, it affects my limbs in different ways, and temperature-wise, with heat and cold, I feel them immensely more than I did before. Everything's hotter than it was before, and everything's colder than it was before. So the first thing that went was swimming. I couldn't get in regular pools to even swim, because I would lose control of my actual arms, and they would just shake uncontrollably because of the cold. So that was the first part that happened. There was one time when I actually was going into my bathroom in our Lake Forest home. Wasn't wearing my robe or nothing. Middle of the night, like 3 a.m., went in there to go to the bathroom, and the air conditioning hit me on the back of the neck just right, and I lost all control of my limbs and my lower limbs and fell forward and almost went through the glass of the shower. And barely caught myself on the back of the toilet before I went through there. So, And then when this first also started happening, there's a couple times when I went to lay down in bed and I wasn't being careful enough because I wasn't used to what was going on with my back and my neck, and pinched something in my lower back where my legs were just flopping around all over the place. I couldn't control them. And another time, and three other times, did the same thing with my neck, not being careful enough, and it pinched a little too hard, and I was actually temporarily paralyzed from the neck down for several hours. And no, it's not sleep apnea. I feel bad for sleep apnea and their sleep demons and all they have to deal with. This has nothing to do with that. So, no, hot yoga will not fix any of this. People are so fucking stupid and rude with their helpful suggestions coming from a good place. Fuck a good place, okay? The path to hell is paved with good intentions. So, shut the fuck up. There's such thing as I have learned. I've always been a very positive person, but I'm a realist too. And I've now learned that I've been toxic positive in the past, and you can be toxic positive. Sometimes people just need to vent. Sometimes people don't need your advice. Sometimes people don't need your positivity. Sometimes people just need you to sit in the darkness with them, or in the pain with them, or in the quiet. That's all they need. They need to be heard, and they need to be listened to. Especially those in pain and with chronic illnesses. These are the kinds of things I never realized before, now that I'm a not fully able-bodied person anymore. And I'm only 46, and there's certain things you can expect your body to do as you get older. None of this is that. This is way beyond that. Even my last doctor fired me, but we'll get into that in another segment. But anyway, here I am in bed because I can't sit up for long periods. Neck issues, so I can't do things at a desk. I learned that a long time ago with using my arms and hands. I just got done with about a month worth of pain where I could barely move my neck. I couldn't even put dishes away. I could barely get dishes out of the cupboards to make myself food. Every time I turned my neck, it was just extreme pain. So it's been a rough month, and that just I woke up yesterday and that was okay. But why am I starting this video health journey? Because my friend Chris Blackburn died 2 days ago. Miss you, Chris. We had a falling out. Don't work with friends sometimes. That's a good reason why. We ended up becoming friends again through pain. See, he was in a car accident and got some bad nerve damage, and then infections, which made nerve damage worse, and some doctor screw-ups, which made some other nerve damage worse. So his nerve damage is way beyond anything I'm dealing with. But having someone who knows what you are dealing with, or is that far advanced to can tell you what you may expect in the future, it was something I needed. And I just hope I was there for him to talk to when he needed to. He wasn't great at opening up about things. I don't, most people knew he had diabetes. A lot of people didn't even know about his nerve issues. But he threw up and choked to death on his own throw up. And that's just one of many ways I fear going because, my throat closes up on me all the time because of a side effect from the first gabapentin. I believe it was, or one of the other ones, tryptophan, blah, 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 blah. Nerve pills that I tried that don't work and just gave me side effects. So that's fun. And then on top of that, the more worse your nerve damage get, and the more less grip you get, and the less control you have of your own body and your own functions, the easier it is to choke on. So I choke on things all the time. My throat just refuses to cooperate. I damn near drowned myself 3 days ago just taking a gulp of water. It happens all the time. It's ridiculous. So actually, yeah, either just my throat closing and stopping breathing is my number one, my number one fear of how I think I'm gonna go, and choking is number two. So Chris going that way was a huge reminder of where I am. And I've had friends ask me to share my journey, and I feel it's time to start talking about it so that way, once I am gone, there's public record of this. This all could have been stopped. This all could have been avoided with proper doctors, proper care, free health care for all, and not insurances that deny everything and our bullshit capitalistic ways, and especially the right wing just against helping their people in this country. It's ridiculous. Like, stop believing the Fox News and Republican lies about how we can't afford it. It's all stupid. You want your taxes going to wars, okay, and to more mass shootings to protect the NRA and all the bullshit going on in this country. Fuck off. Seriously. Yeah.